This meeting to order at 7:30 PM. Roll call.
President Cheris, absent. Vice President Mortis.
Present.
Treasurer Joseph, absent. Parliamentarian Anzalone, present. Executive Secretary Rose.
Present.
Senate Chair Porter.
Present.
Student Trustee Universe.
Present.
Senator Ehrenberg, absent. Senator Badavis.
Present.
Senator Barclay.
Present.
Senator Collins, absent. Senator DePayne. Senator Gilmartin, absent. Senator Leighton, absent. Senator McDonald.
Present.
Senator Murray.
Present.
Senator Parley.
Present.
Senator Quay.
Present.
And Senator Yankton.
Present.
Eight voting members.
Next, we move to approve the agenda for February 8th, 2022. Is there a motion to approve the agenda for February 8th, 2022? Motion made by Senator Parley. Is there a second? Seconded by Senator Murray. Is there anything else for debate or discussion? Seeing none, we move to vote. All those in favor? Opposed? Abstaining? Motion passes 8-0-0. Next, we move to approve the minutes of the meeting for February 1st, 2022. Is there a motion to approve the minutes of the meeting for February 1st, 2022? Motion made by Senator McDonald. Is there a second? Seconded by Senator Quay. Is there anything for debate or discussion? Seeing none, we move to vote. All those in favor? Opposed? Abstaining? Motion passes 7-0-1. Next, we move to invited speakers. Shelly Keniston, Director of the Office of Off-Campus and Commuter Services. As a reminder, we will remain in Robert's Rules. So if you have questions for Shelly, you have to wait for me to call on you. Shelly, I don't have to call on you. but yeah, Shelly, take it away.
Great. So I'm going to send this around. I don't know if I'm allowed to approach. I just want to bring you all a treat that we haven't given out yet this semester in our new location, which I'm going to touch on in a minute. But they're shaped like a car, and they're air fresheners.
Oh, cute.
But you can hang them anywhere if you don't have a car. So take one and pass it around, and I'll collect them at Caitlin on the other side. So I just wanted to bring you a little gift. I just want to touch on a couple of points about the office. So I'm Shelly Keniston. I'm Director of Off-Campus and Commuter Student Services. I've been here at Bridgewater for over 20 years now. Flew by. I worked in residence life and housing for the majority of those years. And then in fall of 2019, late October, I opened the Off-Campus and Commuter Student Services office. It went through a few different names prior to getting to this one that we stuck with. But basically, we were over in the ECC, so you may have known that before. I came to SGA, I think it was either November or, maybe it was probably November of 2019, actually, just to kind of introduce that there was a new office and get some feedback. And I had stayed connected through SGA at the time with Jack. Actually, Mary and I just ran a program prior to coming up here. So we just did a mini town hall. We had a fair amount of students there, but it was a really intimate conversation with some other folks from around campus. Parking, Margarita Vieira for dining and bookstore and all that stuff. And then Dr. Joe O and Mark Carmody joined us a little bit after that. But specifically, we just moved at the beginning of this semester into, if you don't know yet, RSU 007. So between the comment and the info desk, kind of right in the lockers, same floor as SGA office, so we are neighbors. Couple of things that I just want to say about the office, because we're getting this a lot, like kind of like, what do? Or commuters are stopping it, so I've done some email. We actually just had an article come out in the comment this week, or this past week rather, right? And so it was funny, a student walked in, literally with the newspaper, with the page open, he was like, is this place? And he was pointing at it, and I was like, that's us. And he goes, are you Keniston? And I was like, I am. And so, you know, all of the publicity helps in terms of connecting commuter students. And that's kind of what we were charged with initially. So, conversation with President Clark, Dr. Joe O, it really first is making commuters feel like they're part of Bridgewater. So there's a bigger sense of belonging issue that we lose track of sometimes. If you don't know, Bridgewater is 72% commuter students. That's about 8,000. I don't have 8,000 students coming to my office and replying to my emails, because what we also have learned and what we know as I dig more into the data is that a lot of our commuter students are post-traditionally aged commuter students. They are people that have families of their own at home. They are people that are in a career trying to just kind of finish a degree to move on. They're not interested kind of in the traditional college experience like you would think of, but we also need to provide a space for them to come forward with concerns, issues, opportunities for engagement. We've been trying programs at all different times of day. We have found very little success in the 5 to 7 p.m. range. So far, I understand the semester just started, it seems like, so we're sticking with it and we're trying different things. We have a paint night this Thursday night in the office if you want to come paint on a canvas. We did a donut day, however, and that had over 100 commuter students come through. We did gourmet donuts at the Donut King in Weymouth, Phantom Gourmet approved and rated. So we're trying some different things, and part of that, and I understand like some people will talk about like you're just providing food, but we're providing something that gets them in and then hopefully keeps them coming back. So there's certain times a day that there's nobody in there but my staff and I. But there's also times a day that you come in and like it's hard to find a spot. They're plugging in, they're charging, they're talking to each other. Some are just studying with earbuds in. But the space is whatever they want it to be, honestly. So we didn't want to make a lot of decisions and permanent furniture prior to seeing how the space would be used. It also trickles out, so that lounge out there tends to be a lot of commuter students. So we can go out and talk to them, or they'll pop in for something. We do have a few snacks here and there, like commuters forget their lunch. We're talking about the microwaves across campus has come up as a huge issue of concern. I was actually talking to Mary about it a lot. And so we have a microwave. We had worked with Vice President Karen Jason to have the microwave put back into the lounge in Hart Hall, if you didn't know. So they had taken that out for COVID purposes. So we had that put back in, and now it's a matter of kind of publicizing the information. One of the things that my office worked on last semester is changing the hours and access to a place with a bathroom for 6 a.m. because there was issues with the train schedule. So when the train schedule changed, we had a number of students coming in on the 6:20 train. But if you know this campus, nothing opens till 7 a.m. No building opens until 7 a.m. And so we had calls that students were literally standing outside in the rain, sitting on the platform outside of the library, knocking and letting them in, hoping to maintain or let them in. So we got the ECC open, so that's something that you should know. The ECC atrium opens at 6 a.m. and we changed the hours on the commuter lounge on the end cap of Wagon by the parking garage. So that also opens at 6 a.m. So we have two facilities, Monday through Friday, that open for commuters. The ECC was because there was no bathroom access if they went to the Wagon one. So that was another thing that we've worked on. And part of it really is about engagement, like I said, about helping commuters connect. So we all know what happened, right? COVID over the past 2 years. So we had a program designed and in place for first year commuter students. And basically, we didn't get to execute it. So the plan was we would engage them with a commuter ambassador early and help them start to understand and learn being a commuter, how to get engaged, to get involved, promoting some of the pieces that right away they could start to find kind of what they wanted to do and to be part of. So those are some of the things that we're designing and in place for next semester. We've done some of it now. We do work, one of the first things I did was start to connect with landlords in this town that rent to our students, because there was no, truly no line of communication that existed. I now have open communication with over 80 landlords that rent to our students in Bridgewater and a few surrounding towns. We got a new off-campus housing database, if you've seen it or haven't had a chance to. It's far in a way a much better experience, a much better platform. The other one was 22 years old and it was homegrown. home built here. It wasn't even supported by IT anymore. Now landlords upload photos, and our prospective students can look at listings, and it's not just for Bridgewater students. So this is how we're getting people now that are signing up, because they're seeing where they can live without kind of signing and then not finding a place. So it's actually opened a lot of avenues. The landlords are happy, the students have been happy. We've been able to partner. Some faculty and staff have found apartments using that system. One just messaged me and was like, hey, I just moved into an apartment. This is a staff member. He was like, I moved into an apartment in East Bridgewater that I found on your site, so kudos. And I was like, bravo. Well, right? So we are providing resources in different ways. So it's more than the snacks. It's building a space for them to come. So does my office get a lot of parking questions and concerns? Yes. But the thing that I can do is help them connect when they don't know where to go. So we're not keeping those like for ourselves. Like tonight we had Sue Denise there, and we had Margarita Vieira, and Mark Carmody came. And so we can connect them to the right place if they don't know where the right place is. And let me see. Town hall, yeah. And then the only other thing I would say is, like, we're currently pulling a lot of data and working with institutional research. To look at the data that really is about our commuter students and see what else we need to collect and what we don't know. So what I'm interested in is, what don't we know about our commuter students that we need to know to be able to make the best decisions and the best, building the best programs to support them. So some of that comes from focus groups or chats, one-on-ones. Like I learned right away in the program when I met with some focus group students, when the office first opened, is they said, I was a junior before I knew that I could go to bingo. I thought that was just for resident students, right? Like, can you imagine missing 2 years of bingo? And all this time you could have been going and winning the prizes? So part of it is just our website, our Instagram is becoming more popular. I have great students running it. I have 11 students that work for me, 3 grad students, and 8 undergrad students that are doing the programming, that are staff in the office. That's who students get to talk to when they come in. I had a mom that was with her son touring campus the other day, and she was like, so we're thinking about coming here, but it depends, you know, he wants to commute. What are some of the services? So I talked to her for a little while, and then I got an email a few days later, and she was like, he said after he saw the office, he wanted to come there, and I was like, aww. What? Look at that. I don't think it was about me. I think it was that there was a commitment, right, to space, and there was a place, like they saw a place that could be helpful. And so that's all of our spaces, but sometimes it just depends initially what people are looking for and how we can connect. So I'm happy to be partnering with SGA in a few different avenues. Is John here? John? Ah, I think we're doing a wine and cheese event. I told the commuters that were there tonight about it. We don't have an exact date, but happy to partner because I think that our goals are similar in what we're trying to do for all students at Bridgewater, but certainly we need to focus some on commuter students for sure. So that's it, I think, for now. What are questions? Mariah said you can ask a question.
Does anyone have questions for Shelly? Senator Parley.
So this would be a little bit related to the wine and cheese event. Would you be willing to have the commuter ambassador participate in the wine and cheese event to help with the commuters?
Oh yeah, you can have all 11 of them. Whatever you want. They're great with the social media piece, so I would connect you with my social media person, which is actually Andrew Fagan, who used to be, what was he, vice president of
the SGA? He was vice president.
Former vice president, Andrew Fagan. Yeah, so he does all of our social media, but they know that, like, they're working, like, I had 3 there tonight that were just kind of helping, and they have connections with students, so, and I have students now bringing other students in, so that's kind of the draw, but for sure, they would for sure be helping.
Is there any other questions? Student Trustee Universe?
So I asked you this 3 years ago when you first made the office.
I love it.
And I wanted to follow up.
Yeah.
Have you thought about satellite camp, the satellite campuses that we have, such as the Cape Cod campus, and what resources can be provided to those commuter students?
So that's interesting, because right after you asked that, I was talking to Jen Reed, who's at the Cape Cod campus, and then COVID happened, and we haven't, this is like, I feel like we just came out of a little, because I heard Mariah, COVID's still a thing, so, but we're just at a place that we're kind of coming back out. And I think the answer is the Cape Cod campus, I don't think has any students on it currently, right? And so it's working with the, probably the Attleboro and New Bedford to figure out what their programs look like currently. And so if there were, I would partner, I would reach out first to those staff members to see what they're seeing and to make sure they were aware that we had services, right? So that extend beyond it, because I think that's the case, like our facilities here are the ones that do facilities at those places. So I think it would be similar. It's just a matter of figuring out what their needs are and what their timing is. And then if they're here, to make sure that they know we're here, but we're still available virtually and we could have stuff there if there was a need for it, for sure.
Awesome.
So yeah, I mean, I was here, you're right, 2 years ago when I came.
Yeah, pandemic, I didn't expect too much.
Yeah. I was like, I don't know. I mean, I was at home for those 2 years, I feel like, for the most part. But.
Are there any other questions for Shelly?
I do have a question. Can you, like, I was reading the comment, which I stumbled upon in your office with the article being right open on the
table. I did. I had the page open on the table. I was like, hey.
And I saw you mention partnering with SGA to have a bunch of, like, microwaves put around campus. Could you talk a little more about that?
Yeah. So one of the things that we kept getting questions about, especially middle of last semester, and then especially this semester right away, because we had the ribbon cutting day with President Clark, and that day especially, there was a lot of people like, oh, there's a microwave, oh, I see a microwave, like, can we use that, can we use that? So as people started coming in saying, I heard you had a microwave in here, there was just an immediate conversation of, I think this is still a thing, like, they don't realize we had the one put back in Harp, we had the one in Wigan. There is one here, it's small, it's like the microfridge, so if you have a microfridge, it's like just that small one, it's not gonna, I mean, it'll do what it needs to do. And so Mary has been doing her office hours in my office, which is wonderful. And so she was talking, a student had come in and asked me, and then I ended up talking to her about it. And so she said that she was gonna talk to someone here, maybe it was advocacy board, maybe it was to bring it forward, at least on behalf of the commuter students, to see about having a few more put in a few key places. So I was talking to Mark tonight about, because it's not just like we can walk up and throw a microwave somewhere, there has to be like a greater knowledge of it, right? So there's the lounge right outside that would be a great spot because that's a high traffic place, a lot of students are right here and a lot of students have been using ours. Like I said, it's fine, it's just sometimes there's a line. It just is like one of those things, it's like the 6 a.m. thing, like I didn't know that students were coming in on a 6:20 train. Because there's not another option if they have an 8 a.m. class, because the next train doesn't get into like 8:23 or something, so then they're late for class, right? Until that microwave question came up, I forgot, like, if you have been here long enough, the ECC used to have the registers up there, and there was a microwave on this half, and the Bear's Den used to have a microwave where the diner thing is on the inside wall right there. And they got rid of them, and I thought it was due to COVID, and now I don't know. I have a meeting with dining to ask if they could put them back, but, so it's just become a bigger problem. It's again, one of those things that if you're not a commuter student who isn't trying to buy a meal plan and they have food with them, that's a hardship because they're, you know, they're trying to just get by and do what they can do, so. That's one of the things that we've been chatting with, and Mary had said that she would bring forward. She mentioned it again tonight, too. And the students that were in the group tonight had just referenced, like, can we still heat stuff up here? Which, again, is fine, but it's a limited capacity microwave, I guess I would say.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Senator Bergen?
I do have one question. So besides social media, is there any other way you're trying to connect with community students? Because from all my experiences, a lot of commuters didn't even know that you had social media, and neither did I before you mentioned it, so.
Yeah, so, and I know that there's no one way to best reach any student on our campus. So when we try to put stuff out, we try to do the mobile app, we have Facebook, we have Instagram, we try to do student community announcements if possible. I do an email, not overly, not frequently, because I don't want to pile people's inboxes, but I'll do one that has a lot of information in it, and I always add, you should follow us on social media. We've been getting that in the office, some students that are like, I don't do any social media, or someone asked me if I could Snapchat them, and I was like, I cannot, but perhaps somebody can. So we use all those platforms in different ways to try to reach out. So, you know, from my perspective, because I feel like we've done a lot, obviously, I would be like, on the one hand, I would be like, how does someone not know we're here? That means you haven't read, you know, potentially, like, have they not seen, what's the best format? So we're trying to say, okay, so if you don't see it there, where would you see it? So we're trying to just get a sense from people. So where would you see it? Where would you look for information? Or where are you most likely to see it?
Me, personally?
Yeah.
I check my email.
Email.
I see that a lot. But also, I know a lot of kids, when the class closure happened on Friday, they got the text. So maybe seeing if that's an option just for like community students, like sending out a memo, being like, hey, we have this office now. Because that's how I first heard about it. I was at the gym and I got a text about it. And I was like, oh, this is cool.
About my office?
About, no, the class closure. So
I was like, oh. Yeah, those are certainly things to look at. Wait, are you a commuter?
No, I live in
Oh, here. So then you, okay, that makes sense then. I was like, wait, you didn't see my last email? That makes sense, you wouldn't have gotten it. You're not a commuter. Perfect.
Are there any other questions for Shelly? In the gallery, are there any questions? No? All right, thank you, Shelly.
Thanks.
Next, I recommend someone to motion to recall the roll. Senator McDonald.
Motion to recall the roll.
Is there a second? Seconded by Senator Quay. Is there anything for debate or discussion? Seeing none, we'll move to vote. All those in favor? Opposed? Abstaining? Motion passes. 800. Okay. We will recall the roll.
President Cheris, absent. Vice President Mortis.
Present.
Treasurer Joseph, absent. Parliamentarian Anzalone, present. Executive Secretary Rose.
Present.
Senator Porter.
Present.
Student Trustee Universe.
Present.
Senator Ehrenberg, absent. Senator Badavis.
Present.
Senator Barclay.
Present.
Senator Collins.
Present.
Senator DePayne. Senator Gil Martin, absent. Senator Leighton, absent. Senator McDonald.
Present.
Senator Murray.
Present.
Senator Parley.
Present.
Senator Quay.
Present.
And Senator Yankton.
Present.
9 voting members.
Next, we move to club and organization reports. African American Society presents Name That Greek in Moakley Auditorium at 6 p.m. on February 15th, 2022. I believe this is an event that we provided money to. So definitely, if you can, if you're available, check out that event to see what some of our funds are doing. It's always so cool to see it in action. And for more events, check out Engage BSU. Is there anything else for a club and organization reports? Next, we move to executive reports. President.
Hi, everyone. I'm giving President Jarrett his report tonight. He says he's sorry he couldn't make it tonight, and he hopes we have a good meeting, and he'll see us all next week. First thing he wanted me to bring up was committees. If you are unable to serve on a committee due to the schedules not matching up, that is completely okay. Please continue to spread the word to your friends and people you think would be interested in serving on academic committees. Please direct those people to him. You can also direct them to the student announcements that he has submitted. Elections are also coming up, and he hopes to see you all run for re-election next school year, whether that be for a position you currently hold or for another position. If you are thinking of running for an e-board position, he highly encourages to reach out to any e-board member up here to get our perspective. E-board members will be right there for you if you have any questions or concerns. And finally, over the weekend, he sent out an email that he forwarded us all from Dr. O regarding sitting on the Alma Mater Committee. I think I pronounced it, butchered that, I'm so sorry. Dr. O, if you would not mind explaining that during open floor, that'd be great. And that is the end of President Chair's report.
Vice President.
Hello again, everyone. For my VP report, the only thing I have is that we are planning to host an event of Active Minds about positive affirmations. Right after spring break, it will be held in this building. More details will be coming out soon. End report.
Treasurer. No report. Parliamentarian.
Hi, everyone. So Senator McDonald's going to talk a little bit more about what we did last week at Policy Board, but we currently still have two constitutions, and we are in the process of drafting a resolution, which I'll talk more about once we get into it. End report.
Executive Secretary.
Hi, all. Just to update everybody, as you know, this is Black History Month. I've been working on the Instagram a lot and trying to promote all the organizations that we have here, as well as the importance of Black History Month. That is the end of my report.
Student Trustee.
Hello. So I had the pleasure today to go to Student Affairs and Academics. I think I'm dyslexic and got those names confused. Committee, as well as Finance and Operations Committee and Alumni Development Committee, which are all board trustee committees. I have some excellent information on new programs that will be starting here. I got some updates on capital planning projects. And I learned some cool things about our endowment and what's going on there. I also, over the past month, have had the pleasure of sitting on the Department of Higher Ed 10-year strategic plan for equity and race steering committee. That is a long name. And I have really had a moment to see how not just Bridgewater functions, but how the state functions when it makes plans for the future. If any senators are available to attend a Board of Trustees meeting at 5 p.m. on February 22nd, which is a Tuesday, I would love to see you there. Please Teams message me or email me. It's a really amazing way to see how decisions are made at the high level of governance that this university provides. And it makes me feel less lonely. So I would love to see you all there. End of report.
Senate Chair. So Laura Beekler of Financial Aid will be attending Senate on March 15th, and BSU Dining will be attending Senate on March 1st. I'm also waiting back on a few other emails, so there will be more people coming soon. Also, I notice a pattern tonight. If it is business casual, that does not include jeans. So if the first time, fine. The second time, you will not be marked as present on roll. So please, if it is business casual, do not wear jeans. And committee reports, if you went to a committee, make sure you submit an agenda item by Friday at noon, or it will be pushed back a week. And if you attend a committee, you need to submit a committee report on Engage BSU. Just giving one here is not enough. And if you have any questions on how to do that, please feel free to reach out. End of report. Board reports, Executive Board.
Hi, everyone. So President Chairs is going to be meeting with the new community liaison this Thursday. This meeting will be both an introduction meeting between both of them and go over the Community Building Day stack resolution. And he's looking forward to him coming to a Senate meeting to introduce himself to you and answer any of our questions. Other than that, today at eBoard, we just talked about what all of our specific boards did this week. End report.
Next, we move to Advocacy Board.
Hi, everyone. Advocacy Board did not meet this week due to the snow day. We are meeting this Friday at 5:30 in the SJ office and over to the end report.
Finance Board, they did not meet. Policy Board.
Policy Board meets every Thursday at 5, and Senator McDonald's going to be giving a report.
So last week at Policy Board, we discussed the Constitution for the Indigenous Cultures Allies Association. It is included in the agenda. And later tonight, we will have some representatives from there talk a bit more about the Constitution and then what they want to do. And we will vote on whether or not to kind of ratify it and report.
Next, we move to Public Relations Board.
Hi again. No meeting last week due to the weather. We do meet every Friday from 3 to 4 online. And other things we're going to be working on in Public Relations Board is decorating our student government door in honor of Black History Month, as well as infographics for SGA, just to promote us as a whole. And then once that is completed, we're working on reaching out to tour guides and O-team to promote SGA. End of report.
Elections Board. We did not meet on Friday because of the snow day, but we will be meeting this Friday, 10 to 11, to go over election rules more in depth. So if you're on Elections Board, the election rules I sent in the chat a few, like 2 weeks ago when we had our board meeting. So definitely look over those, and we will be looking on how to make sure they're more specific when it comes to social media campaigning. End report. Next, we move to committee reports. Undergraduate Curriculum Committee submitted by Andrew McDonald, Senator at Large. Senator McDonald?
No report.
All right. Next, we move to All University Committee reports submitted by Andrew McDonald, Senator at Large. Senator McDonald?
I do have a report for that one. So last Wednesday, All University Committee met and we had passed a few courses for Portuguese phonetics and phonology, intro to Latinx and Caribbean diaspora, sustainability, innovation, and leadership, basic theory of musicianship, and other music courses, however, were tabled because where there was no representative. Marketing, a marketing internship course was passed along with Physics 181 E and T, which were linked courses, and Sociology 380 were passed. End of report.
Are there any questions for Senator McDonald?
Yes.
Student Trustee Universe?
Are those physics courses specifically for the photonics major?
Senator McDonald? I don't believe so. I believe that in it they were said to, I think they were for like outside majors and things for that, but they were connected. I can give you a copy of the like actual list of what it was after the meeting if you'd like.
Parliamentarian Anzalone.
Physics 181 is like a basic physics class, like chemistry majors take it, bio majors, like I took it. But the E and the T is, I don't know if you ever took a math class, it means that you would just be assigned a PAL. So you'd have a PAL in the class with you. Like, so you'd have 24-hour access to like a tutor.
That's cool.
Any other questions for Senator McDonald? All right, next we move to discussion of space committee meeting submitted by Senator John Parley, Senator at Large.
Hey everyone. So I attended space committee meeting last week and we talked about a couple things and some stuff to really know would be they're planning on removing the computers from Harrington and maybe turning it into a potential lounge or space to study. Harrington 202 will become a study space, most likely, creating more space for graduate students. And there was a space request presented for the Hart Hall Room 118 for social work and psychology students, and potentially having the food truck move to Moakley sometimes. End report.
Any questions for Senator Parley? Seeing none, is there anything else? Oh, Senator Murray?
The place in Hart, that 118, that was just for psych, for those two majors that you said, why is it just for those two majors and not everyone? Is there a reason?
That's where that's where the main classes are held, social work and psychology, but they're not gonna be like, no, you can't come in, like, it's gonna be open for everyone, but it's geared towards those students. Oh. Any other questions? Anything else for committee reports? Seeing none, we move to old business. Is there anything for old business? Seeing none, we move to new business. Motion number 8, move to approve the Constitution for Indigenous Culture and Allies Association, submitted by Lex Anzalone, parliamentarian, sponsored by Austin Murray, Senator at Large. Is there a second? Seconded by Senator McDonald. If there are representatives for ICAA, you have the floor.
Hi everyone, my name is Deja Peters. I'm the secretary of ICAA.
And I'm Carrie Provost, and I'm the vice president.
So just to tell you guys a little bit about our club, the goals are really just to have a space for Indigenous students on campus to, you know, feel like a community and to kind of build that Native community on campus, but also for non-Native students, anyone who's interested, to just learn about Indigenous, you know, history, present day events, and just topics like that. We plan on having lots of different events, depending on the time of year. So last semester we had like Thanksgiving, you know, debunking the myth of Thanksgiving. We've done other like panels on Zoom, things like that, and just advocating for Native, you know, rights, social justice type of things. And we also just plan on, you know, having fun, just making a community of people to have on campus. We are going to meet every other Wednesday here in RSU. Not sure if there's anything else you guys have any questions.
Are there any questions for our representatives? All right, so now we're going to vote on approving it. All those in favor? Opposed? Abstaining? Motion passes 8-0-1. Congratulations. You are now here. Is there anything else for new business? Seeing none, we move to open forum. Is there anything for open forum? Student trustee universe?
So, I have noticed a pattern between a few members of this organization when it comes to pronoun use. My pronouns are they, them, theirs. If you do not understand why I use those pronouns, I'd be happy to explain them to you, that to you privately. If you need additional readings to understand why I use these pronouns or why these pronouns are valid, I would be happy to supply those to you privately. I do expect everybody in this organization to use my pronouns correctly. And I'm sorry if that makes you feel uncomfortable, but my identity is not open to discomfort. And this is not me trying to be rude. If you have genuine questions, I would be happy to explain them. Awesome. And if anybody has any questions, I can try to answer them. And also, queer people are not a monolith, and I do not speak for all queer people.
Yeah. All right, anything else for open forum? Dr. Joseph Orbeck, Vice President of Student Affairs and Enrollment Management.
Thank you, and President Cherist asked me to provide any additional clarification for the email that you all received that was forwarded to you all. With regard to the opportunity for some student representative on the Alma Mater Committee. So, Alma Mater is an ode in song to the university, to which we do have one, which has typically been sung at commencement. However, part of the Spirit Committee has been to further refine the current Alma Mater. So there is a tune which has been refined just a little bit. And now the words, the lyrics, are looking to be updated. So last semester there was a call or a contest that was placed in student announcements as well as community announcements for those that are interested in submitting lyrics to the Alma Mater to do so by a certain date. And that was done. Now, part of the committee, the committee is now wanting to make sure that there's student representation to be able to look at those submissions, to which I believe there's 8 to 10 submissions to that, to then, and it really will be about a two meeting process to then be able to narrow down and make the ultimate recommendation to the president for the new lyrics to the alma mater. So that hopefully gives a little bit better clarification as far as the role, time commitment, and Vice President Paul Jean, who is Vice President of Marketing Communications, is the chair of that committee. And what I did ask of him was that generally all the time when we provide opportunities for students to serve on committees, the first thing you're wanting, well, maybe the second or third thing, besides what's the committee about, is what day of the week is the meeting going to be and what time of the day is that going to be? And so he has not set those times. However, he is privileging the student schedule so that it would be a scene if we're able to have two students. And I have received some names, but the door is, or the window has not been closed yet. My hope is to receive final names by tomorrow. And then I will be able to afford those names for them, the committee, and him to decide, okay, this is who we need to, we would like to provide that opportunity. And then the time of the meeting, the day of the meeting, and the time of the meeting will be set. And I think it should be a really incredible opportunity, quite honestly, to be able to be part of the decision-making process for the long term, so that eventually that this alma mater is not just sung at commencement, that it's part of the institution. So at any point in time, be it sporting games, be it at a variety of student events, that could be infused into tradition. I mean, you're able to have that opportunity. So I'm happy to take any questions with regard to that.
Are there any questions?
So if you're interested, just shoot me an email or I think the majority of you follow me on Instagram, send me a DM. So that's generally quick, and so I can just have your information then, and I can take it from there. All right, thank you.
I do have a question for you, Dr. Joe.
Yes.
But not about the committee.
Oh, okay.
So, I've talked to a lot of people, and there's a lot of concerns about the ice still going on. I was talking to a maintainer in this building, because I like basically live in this building, and she was okay, I'm gonna go like get rid of the ice, and did not receive, like she went into the closet and just, there was literally no like rock salt or anything, and there's like a lot of locations on this campus that are still super duper icy. I know there are crosswalks that still aren't really like super shoveled out, like they're still like kind of slushy grossness, especially like between DMF and here. So like, I know we're super understaffed, which I completely get, but it's starting to become a safety concern. So are there any like updates as to like if maintainers are receiving more salt, if like something's being done to try to make sure that like it can be done quicker, or if there's, I don't know.
So this is where it takes a community and the eyes that we all have to be able to kind of like, well, how do I let someone know if I'm walking somewhere as opposed to, this is the fifth time that I'm walking by this spot and it's still icy and no one is doing that. So how might we be able to send, and it's more or less through school, dude, is there anything else, Caitlin, that you can offer? But that's kind of where I know that's what I've done to be able to, of some spots, I'm like, I'm in an area that I don't know how regularly it's traversed, but I need to inform facilities that I just passed by a spot so that they can put in their queue to be able to then treat it. So that's in part, Caitlin. I'm sorry.
Advisor Caitlin J. Dileski.
With something like that, when something is urgent, facilities in the past has asked for students to directly call the main line for customer service, which is 1296 if you're calling from a campus phone, or 508-531-1296. 1296 to get it fixed is what Keith McDonald used to like to say, and it's stuck in my brain ever since. So that's much more urgent than school dude, because school dude has to go through a processing and like be moved to the people. But if you call directly, they'll be able to dispatch somebody as quickly as they can get somebody over to wherever that spot is. So that's the fastest way. I also do want to address, I was receiving a lot of feedback, particularly about the Summer Street ramp. There was a design flaw, so as soon as it's a little warmer and drier, the contractor who did that recently is going to come back and redo it, because we've been having a lot of issues with the ramp, and that we're very aware. I've been in contact with capital planning and facilities, and they are addressing it and trying to find some temporary fixes until we can get the contractor back. So just know that that was heard, and we are trying to address it as quickly as possible.
So I'm wondering then if we might be able to partner in informing the campus community as far as how to, if you come across an icy spot, knowing that there's constant eyes, how might someone report it? Can we do through on the mobile app, through SGA, and just posting saying, hey, notice an icy spot, call 1296, that sort of process, so we can point people? Because it is a responsibility that we all have, as opposed to someone saying, not my job, right?
So follow-up question to that, like the garage, for instance, like why is, like we all, like everyone knows people park there, like why do we actually keep calling about it? Like we know that's a high traffic spot, why wasn't it taken care of?
No, you're absolutely right, and that was something that I asked Vice President Jason this morning. With regard to how are we managing that. And so she was following up with Mark Carmody and BU. So I don't know what sort of activity actually happened today, but you're absolutely right. And I do not have an answer with regard to it, but I'm hopeful that that has been addressed.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes.
Anything else for an open forum? Seeing none, we move to Senator Collins.
Hi, I was wondering if we're going to like be working, not working, but like doing anything with the Tillinghast building. I know that the kitchen is out of date, but the whole space has been like kind of compromised and like it's kind of a waste.
The plan is to reopen it in the fall.
Okay. I was just wondering.
Advisor Caitlin Jadaleski.
Tilly's being studied for a lot of different renovation projects, but that stuff takes time and funding. So they are slowly working towards renovating piece by piece in certain areas. So it is definitely a building that's under review for all kinds of updates.
That makes sense. Yeah. Thank you.
Absolutely. Anything else for the forum? Senator Barclay.
Hi, I just had a quick question about the greenhouse. I know it sustained a little bit of damage. Do we have any plans to fix it, or what's...
Advisor Caitlin Jadaleski?
Yes, that was talked at the operation status meeting last week. It is, they're working on getting the vendor back out. I know they did some minor repairs and they're finishing those up, but it should be fixed up very soon. If it has, I think because we got more snow, it kind of reopened, but they're working on it.
Anything else for Senator Barclay?
Just one more thing. I'm sorry.
I
had a couple students come to me about concerns for a spring lot. I mean, I'm never over there because I'm not a commuter, so I have no idea how bad it is. But would it be possible? It's really possible that it's just there's nowhere else to put the snow, but there's concerns that they put the snow's kind of still in some parking spaces, and it's very limited on this campus. Is there any place else that we could potentially put it? I mean, it's probably just like there's no other space, but I was just wondering.
And also to speak on that, the parking garage is still covered with residents, so it's taking away very vital parking for commuters. And I know we talked about it in Student Advisory Board last semester, and genuinely does not seem like it's improved at all.
It hasn't, okay. Part of my pattern of what you all really don't need to know, but I'll share it with you. Every Saturday and Sunday, I go up and down the, very early in the morning, going up and down the parking garage just so I can kind of get a sense as to where students are going and so, and the condition and such to be able to understand that. So that's helpful for me to know that if it feels as though it is that way, that I need to be able to follow up with regard to that. For Spring Lot, that came up in the commuter student town hall this evening. And so Mary, when she brought that up, Dr. Mark Carmody was present, and he was surprised to hear that. So that was 2.5 hours ago, so that he was going to then try to follow up and see what is going on with regard to that. So, okay.
Advisor Caitlin Gidaleski.
I'm also curious, and again, I haven't frequented Spring, but I'm also wondering if that's the town lot that's on the back end of it, or if it's our property, but it should be 55 degrees on Friday and Saturday, so hopefully we will have some snow melt, and hopefully that will help assist with some of these issues. I know that that doesn't fix it in the moment, and as students are trying to coordinate themselves back to campus, I get that, but you know, there was a lot of snow, so there isn't a lot of places for us to dump it, unfortunately.
All right, anything else? Executive Secretary Rose.
I just have a quick question. Has there been any like kind of talk of Bridgewater State University sort of implementing scanners for the cars, like commuters as well as residents? I don't know if anybody's seen the Stonehill campus, but they actually scan in all of their cars to individual like getting in and out of the campus. I think that would be just interesting to hear about.
Student trustee Universe.
My first and immediate reaction to that is I don't believe there's been any talks, and I can't imagine how much money that would cost.
I know in the parking pass, the parking sticker, there's some like there's like a barcode or whatever in that scan, so there's like a parking map. So like Spring Lot and I believe the garage have it, so you can kind of see how many people are in there. But that's what I know. For tracking-wise, what they have so far. Advisor Caitlin Jadaleski.
Just for context, because it's been a bit, that program really got started right before COVID, and we had just started to expand into Spring, so it had been in the garage for about a year. They added Spring, and there were plans to continue expanding to Lake Hooper and some other lots, but obviously that was paused. So that's a great conversation to maybe perhaps bring back to traffic and parking and see if there's any interest in reviving that project or having conversations about expanding it.
All right, is there anything else for open forum? Dr. Joe?
I'd love to just piggyback on that, just to kind of carry or pull the string here. And that's overall of what we are experiencing last semester and now this semester. And you've heard me say this term, that we're in the next normal. And so even with commuter students, that this is the first spring semester in 2 years. So we have not had a full complete spring semester for 3 years. So all of this, the pattern of how people get to the university, how you walk the university, and all the events that are happening, the majority of our students, you all, don't know what it was like 3 years ago. And so all these new patterns, you have the opportunity of informing us as to this is the way things are. Because to go back to things, this is the way that we used to do it pre-COVID, is not where we should be going. We need to understand how behavior has changed because of COVID. So that's kind of where my hope, and for the student leadership, that to be able to share that what was done in the past, that's fine, but that's in the past. And how have things changed, and how can we reinforce that, and to use those lenses to be able to say we're now in the next, and after that will be another next. But how do we as student leaders be able to think through that? And that was a little bit of a conversation that we had at the commuter student town hall, but these are conversations that I'm having within the Division of Student Affairs and Enrollment Management in different pockets of student organizations. And I offer that for you all to think through, to be able to see if that is a frame of reference that might further help when you're working with advocacy board and a variety of other perspectives. So, thank you.
All right, Senator Barkley.
And just one last thing for you, Dr. Jo. Last semester, I brought up the issue of RAs and their, I don't know what the word I'm looking for, but RAs being able to administer CPR if it's necessary. Is there any updates on that?
Yes.
So what we have clarification of is that if you are trained, if you are a trained individual, that it's the Good Samaritan that you should be able to, as opposed to no colonel. It is, again, if you are trained and certified,
right,
to be able to do that. Okay. Yes.
Right.
Student trustee Universe.
Is there a way that could just be communicated to RAs? Like, it can, just because, like, we have weekly staff meetings, might be a good thing to just be like, hey, by the way, if you know how to do CPR and you're certified, please do it in a case where you might need to.
Okay. I will circle back, making sure that we're all saying the same thing. Thank you.
All right, anything else for open forum? Seeing none, we move to announcements.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back after a short week of snow days. There will be some newly arriving furniture down in Summer Street on Friday, so come check that out as you walk through the building. It'll start to almost finish what is a lengthy project in that area. So come see that. Other than that, stay warm and walk like a penguin so that you don't fall down in all aspects of your life. Parking lots for stores as well, because those are pretty bad too.
Hi, everyone.
That's fine. No announcements.
Sorry.
Hi, guys. Thank you for approving our club. We've been waiting to be approved since August. One of our main events that our board forgot to mention is we're doing a presentation about AIM, which is the American Indian Movement. We're going to focus on the occupation of Winnetney, where you were in a lot of the American tribes banded together and was in a shootout with the FBI. And that would be on Liberation Day, which is February 23rd, our first meeting. And announcements.
Hi, friends. I hope you all are well. And I have a joke for you all because I'm just the funniest. So. Why can't you have a nose that's 12 inches long?
Why? Because then it's a foot.
Because it would be a foot. Anyway, that's all.
Hi, guys. I have two announcements today. I just want to thank you all for showing up today. It's super cool. The dedication of, you just coming and participating is a really big deal. And I really just want to express that I appreciate you all for doing that. My other announcement isn't about me, but it's about my twin sister. And I'm actually really proud of her because she joined a club at BSU. She's also a freshman. And she isn't really the type of person to do that. So I just want to say how proud of I am.
Yeah.
And
that's I love that your sister joined a club. I have no announcements, just stay safe.
I can't get over the fact that you're a twin. I want to see both of you, next. Do you look alike?
No, but we're the same height.
Okay, sorry. Anyway, I hope everyone's having a good week. Last week I found out that I got into grad school. So I'm nice to know what I'm doing for the rest of my life. That's it. I hope you all stay safe, stay warm, do your homework, get some rest. That's it.
It was already mentioned by the lovely Shelly Keniston, but Keniston, I don't know how to speak. But I do know how to put together a newspaper, and on that note, the comment is out and available to read. We do have a little bit of a weird distribution this week. And I promise it won't be this weird in the future, because we generally get our paper on Thursday. For some reason, it was delivered on Friday, and then none of the board members have confessed to it, but somebody had taken the paper and just threw it everywhere in RSU.
Weird.
So, promise that won't happen again. But if you find it anywhere in RSU, or in any other buildings, which have designated spots where they are, then read it. We have amazing stories on Commuter, the new Commuter office location. The Ukraine and Russia issue thing that's happening that might start World War III and scariness. I don't like world news, it's terrifying. An amazing sports section. This is the first time I can say this as a creative director. I think sports has the best section this issue, which is wild because usually our campus life is pretty good. And some of the, in my opinion, some of the best art that we've ever featured. The Comet also has two stories that are just living on our website now. We are kind of stuck publishing only 8 pages. So we are having stories live on our website. So if you're interested in a little bit of a pre-Super Bowl moment, as well as how Congress is dealing with whether they should be able to buy stocks, then you can go to the comment and read it. Our website's under a little bit of a revamp this semester. We switched platforms last semester, and I have set time aside in my schedule to make sure our website looks good, because it did not look good last semester. So go read the comment. Greek Life is still recruiting at Apple. Greek Life's not for everybody, but if you would like to go out for it, I believe 3 of the 4 sororities said that they would COB.
All sororities.
All 4 of the Benelux sororities are COBing, and I believe most of the fraternities are still in their recruitment weeks. You can go to the FSLC Instagram to find out all that information, or individual organization pages. Other than that, enjoy. End of announcements.
Hello, everyone. We have a food pantry on campus, so if you or any of your friends need a little pick-me-up, I know we all still have dining dollars in our swipes, but towards the end of the semester when you're running out, we do have a food pantry downstairs. So yeah, just go check it out. I think we have a lot of ramen probably still, a lot of macaroni and cheese, if that's your thing, we have a lot of that. You can also volunteer there if you'd like to help out. Dawn is the intern there right now, so you can email her if you'd like to do that. But Brad, anything else? Just send her an announcement.
No announcements.
Not this meeting feels like it's missing an inspirational quote, right, guys?
I have one ready to go.
Oh, I got a better one.
You know what? Say yours.
So, yesterday is history. Tomorrow is mystery. Today's a gift. That's why it's called the present. By Master Yu Guai.
Cute.
End of announcement.
Dr. O, do you announce it?
I have already provided one, so I'm good. Thank you.
So quote from Josh. Not from Josh, but it gives me Josh energy. if you don't get serious about your money, you'll never have serious money. He would say that. I feel that. And a fun fact about any board member is that Executive Secretary Rose is a twin. Have a good week. Take care of yourself. Get some sleep. Make sure you eat. With that, we move to adjournment. I didn't adjourn yet. I now call this meeting adjourned at 8:33 p.m.